Well, hey, schools are open, you know? I've been going down towards Tall Timbers, and I've been driving Route 5, and a little flower over there. Boy, do they have a drop-off in the morning. Hey, that line's all the way out down Route 5, and it's interesting that those kids are going back to school, and I wish them the best, and watch out for the school buses. Obviously, there's not as many. In that same regard, I know my granddaughter, and it's not about her, it's about children in general, started her new Schoology yesterday. And while it was successful, it did have its glitches, and they worked it out. And all in all, I want to say it sounds like it started out okay. Let's hope the first marking period is 10 weeks, and when it's over with, kids can go back to school. Because I do have to say, when I will talk about my own granddaughter, she's not the type of person that likes to raise her hand a lot or interject a lot, and she probably needs to be drawn out by a teacher. So there's a lot of kids like that, that will do better when they're in a classroom environment with other kids. So let's hope that this COVID's on the way out and we can get our schools back to normal. Getting a lot of complaints about Atlantic Broadband, and obviously with the schools starting and the telecommuting that's been going on, internet is very, very important. Look, we get it. We get it. But like we need that people to understand is that the infrastructure, all the lines and the stuff on the poles and all that stuff is owned by Atlantic Broadband. It was owned by Metrocast before, and when Atlantic Broadband bought them, they bought all their infrastructure. The key in 2020 is competitors don't want to come into a rural area like St. Mary's County and install additional infrastructure. It's tens, if not hundreds of millions of dollars to do that. And by the time they get it in, or if they were to get it in, who knows what's going to happen with wireless, whether it be drones, 5G, whatever we keep hearing about. So we're stuck with Atlantic Broadband. Now, I encourage people to start petitions. Understand that you need to keep Atlantic Broadband feet to the fire, that we are not happy with their service. I'm not happy with their service, but it's all I got. And unless I want to go HughesNet or DirecTV or something else that seems to be less reliable than the cable, it's what we have. But stay vigilant on making them provide better service. And stay vigilant on making elected officials, when we have our chance to talk to these executives from these cable companies, that they're doing their best that they can do, because what we're hearing is not good. And I agree, if you're upset with it, call us, sign petitions, but understand, we want competition. If we could get several providers in here and they could come in tomorrow, hey, I'd vote for that in a heartbeat. But there's just, people have done analysis and they've understood that the cost involved in coming down here is just too prohibitive. So please understand, the commissioners have no benefit by letting Atlantic Broadband in here and trying to keep competition out. Anybody who thinks we do, that is not true. Lastly, sports. I am a guy that wants to say either let them play or put them all in clinics. It just doesn't make sense that if my kid wants to play soccer, lacrosse, or field hockey, well, that's got to be clinics. But if he wants to play softball, baseball, or dodgeball, it's okay. I still have a disconnect with that. But I understand it's about safety. It's about scientific data, metrics that we're receiving. And hopefully that will be reversed too. Maybe by the September 12th date, we can start all sports. Thank you.